Recital, because he's interested in studying music in a serious way now, and he's been a student of mine. And Ruth Kays, where is Ruth? Can you stick your hand up, Ruth, so people can see where you are? Okay. And we welcome his grandmother and his parents here, and all of you, actually. And so we'll turn it over to Callum. He grew up in Bridgewater and in Ontario. While he was here, he went to school here, and then when he graduated from school, he went to Ontario to work with his dad, and now he's back. Good to see you back, Callum.
Hi. A lot of friends and family came to this. I want to thank everybody for coming, especially my dad, because he just drove out from Ontario, and that's him there. First piece I'm going to play is called Fantasy by Mozart, and it's a kind of an opera piece, so he started writing it when he was starting to write his operas and stuff. It kind of tells a story, so you can figure out what he's trying to say. The next one tells a story too. It's called Tuba Mirum, which is in Latin. It is the wondrous trumpet. So I'll just read the lyrics in English. The trumpet will send its wondrous sound throughout earth's sepulchres and gather all before the throne. Death and nature will be astounded when all creation rises again to answer the judgment. A book will be brought forth in which all will be written, by which the world will be judged. When the judge takes his place, what is hidden will be revealed, nothing will remain unavenged. And what shall a wretch like me say? Who shall intercede for me when even the righteous ones need mercy? I got a bunch of pieces from Mozart's last Requiem in D minor. Beautiful Requiem. I won't be playing all of them, but there's four or five from it. So this one's in B flat major. Thank you. Next one is by Debussy, Claude Debussy. Song about a flax-haired girl. Debussy was one of the first to use chords that are now popular in jazz music. So he was like a classical composer, but he invented lots of the beginnings of jazz, which is cool. The next one is by Mozart again, Lacrimosa, which means mournful. It's a prayer for salvation and rest. I was thinking we could take an intermission. Does anybody want to? I don't know. Keep going if you want, but. Okay, I guess we'll keep going. This next one is by Chopin. It was written in 1842, and his father had just died, and his friend had just died, so pretty sad time in his life, and you can hear it, because it's... But I think he got through the process of grief pretty well. It kind of does a turnaround at the end.
Thank you.
Has anybody heard Moonlight Sonata before? Beethoven actually wrote it when he was deaf, so whatever you can take from that. It's a beautiful song.
Thank you.
I think we should take a 5-minute break. Washrooms are downstairs if you go this way down the hall, and then they're on the left. Okay.
Thank you.
Next one is a prelude by Bach in C minor. And back to the Requiem. The next one's Domine Jesu, which is Lord Jesus. It's a pleading for the King of Glory to deliver the faithful departed from the fires of hell. So it kind of like jumps back and forth. It's quite the piece.
Thank you.